各位亲爱的弟兄姐妹平安，欢迎您收看今天的空中主日崇拜节目。这个节目是由加略山华人基督教会为您所制作的，让我们存着敬畏和感恩的心，一起来敬拜这位三位一体的真神。
天上荣耀将我心灵充满，Heaven came down and glory filled my soul.
哦，我的 wonderful, wonderful day, day I will never forget. After I wandered in darkness away, Jesus my Savior I met.Tender, compassionate friend, he met the need of my heart. Shepherds expanding with joy and in telling he may all the darkness depart. Heaven came down and glory filled my soul. When at the cross the Savior made me whole.生命有生灵而生，进入神圣的家中。因加略山的爱，我的真意，何等福气与庄重。我是个罪人，来到主面前，主赐我赦罪恩典。他已拯救我，赞美他的生命，我今天受此大恩典。在天家主为我预备住处，荣耀终与主同住，都因那奇妙难忘的日子，是加下我的祈求。永远的福气及丰盛的赏赐，天从他恩手中接受，天上荣耀将我心将我
是全世界与我。Jesus is all the world to me.
Jesus is all the world to me. My life, my joy, my
弟兄姐妹平安。
Peace be with you all.
今天我要跟大家分享信息的题目是基督耶稣的教会，经文出自彼得前书第一章一到二节。
Today, my message is titled The Church of Jesus Christ, and the scripture that we will be focusing on is 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 1 through 2.
大家知道耶稣基督的教会分布世界每一个城乡角落。
Everyone knows that the Church of Jesus Christ is located throughout the entire world in the urban and local areas.
几乎有人生活的地方就有耶稣的教会。
Wherever there is people, there is the Church of Christ.
你问教会究竟是什么？
You ask, what exactly is the Church?
它与别的团体有什么不同呢？
How is it different from other groups?
教会是堂皇华丽的建筑物吗？
Is the church a big building?
教会是一般虔诚的信徒聚集在礼拜堂里面敬拜吗？
Is the church a group of devout believers that gather together to worship the Lord?
教会是充满爱心、热心、行善的群体吗？还是教会有着深刻的属灵意义？
Or rather, is the church a community full of loving and enthusiastic people doing good work?
今天我们将从圣经彼得前书第一章一到二节思想耶稣基督的教会。
Today, we are going to study the Church of Jesus Christ from 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 1 through 2.
圣经说，耶稣基督的使徒彼得写信给分散在本都、加拉太、加帕多加、亚西亚、皮推尼寄居的，就是照父神的先见被拣选，借着圣灵得成圣洁，以致顺服耶稣基督，又蒙他血所洒的人，愿恩惠平安多多加给你们。
The chapter begins with Peter, an apostle of Jesus Christ, to those who reside as strangers scattered throughout Pontus, Galatia, Cappadocia, Asia, and Bithynia, who are chosen according to the foreknowledge of God the Father by the sanctifying work of the Spirit to obey Jesus Christ and be sprinkled with his blood. May grace and peace be multiplied to you.
以上的经文讲论耶稣基督教会的三个方面。
The verses I just read talked about three aspects of the Lord Jesus' church.
第一，主耶稣借着彼得写信给教会。
First, the Lord Jesus wrote to the church through Peter.
第二，教会是如何建造起来的。
The second aspect focuses on how the church was built.
第三，主耶稣向教会所怀的意念，以下我们一一思考。
Third, we'll look at the thought that the Lord Jesus had toward the church. Now let's study this all together.
现在我们讲信息的第一方面，耶稣基督借着彼得写信给教会。
First, let's look at the Lord Jesus who wrote the letter to the church through Peter.
彼得写信的格式与当时人们写信的格式一样，就是写信的人、收信的人加上问安的话语。
Now the format of Peter's letter at that time consisted of the one who was writing the letter, the one who received the letter, and the words of greeting.
从字面上看，这书信是彼得写给教会的，实际上是主耶稣通过彼得写的。
Now this letter was written by Peter to the church, but the Lord Jesus wrote it through Peter.
首先彼得说，耶稣基督的使徒彼得写信。
First, Peter says, Peter, an apostle of Jesus Christ, writes.
从希腊文的字义看，使徒是奉差遣的意思。
The word apostle in Greek means the one who is sent out.
这里彼得是指笔写信的人，却是受主耶稣的托付写信。
Here, Peter is the one who writes the letter, but he is entrusted by the Lord Jesus to write.
彼得依仗主耶稣的权柄写信。
And so Peter relies on the authority of the Lord Jesus to write this letter.
彼得代表主耶稣的心意写信。
Peter writes on behalf of the will of the Lord Jesus.
你问彼得是谁，主耶稣为什么如此重用他呢？
A question. Who is Peter? And why did the Lord Jesus use him so much?
答案从福音书跟使徒行传可以找到，让我们做一个简单的回顾。
Now the answer can be found in the Gospels and in the book of Acts. Let's take a look at that.
在没有跟随主耶稣之前，彼得是加利利的一个渔夫。
Before following Jesus, Peter was a fisherman in the land of Galilee.
有一天，主耶稣呼召他，他应主之召，就舍了渔船，别了父亲，跟随了耶稣。
Now one day, Jesus called out to Peter to follow him, and Peter responded. He dropped his fishing boat, he left his father, and he went to follow Christ.
三年半之久，主耶稣无论往哪里去，彼得总跟主在一起。
For 3.5 years, Peter was always with Jesus wherever he went.
他亲耳听耶稣讲道，亲眼看耶稣行神迹，多次亲身经历主耶稣的能力彰显在他的身上。
He heard when Jesus preached the sermon to the masses. He saw the miracles that Jesus performed, and he even experienced the power that was manifested in Jesus in many, many times.
他更是见证主耶稣在十字架上的受苦，见证主耶稣的埋葬，见证主耶稣的复活。
He also witnessed the suffering of Jesus on the cross, the burial of Jesus, and the resurrection.
主耶稣复活升天以后，彼得被圣灵充满，与其他的门徒从耶路撒冷到犹太全地，到撒玛利亚，到各处传扬耶稣的福音，建立教会，牧养主的羊群，坚固信徒。
Now after Jesus rose from the dead and ascended to heaven, Peter was filled with the Holy Spirit. Together with all the other disciples, they traveled to Jerusalem and to the whole region of Judea and to Samaria to preach the gospel of Christ. They also built churches, they shepherded the flocks, and they strengthened the believers.
最后，彼得在罗马皇帝尼罗执政的时候为主殉道。
In the end, Peter was martyred for the Lord during the reign of the Roman Emperor Nero.
彼得跟随主耶稣的前后显然是两个人生。
So we see the before and the after. We can notice that there is a definite change. His life was completely transformed.
彼得以前是个渔夫，他所注重的是捕更多的鱼，赚更多的钱，做更大的生意。
Before, Peter was a fisherman. He wanted to catch fish, more fish to get more money to expand his business.
但是他跟从主之后，就舍弃世界的工作，专心爱主，爱教会，满有圣灵的能力和属灵的知识，为真理做见证。
But after he followed Jesus, he abandoned his work of the world, and he devoted himself to loving the Lord and the Lord's people. He was full with the power of the Holy Spirit and with spiritual knowledge. He was a witness to the truth.
现在我们思想信息的第二方面，教会是如何建造起来的。
Now let's look at the second aspect. How was the church built?
经文用六个短句告诉我们教会是如何建造起来的。每一个描述都很独特，很中肯，精简地将教会属灵的意义讲论出来。
The scripture uses 6 sentences to tell us how the church was built. And each description is unique, relevant, and concise. Each one speaks out to the spiritual meaning of the church.
第一，教会分布在不同的地方。
First, the church was located in many different places.
教会最初在耶路撒冷被建立。
The church was first established in the city of Jerusalem.
众人聚集在一起敬拜主，充满主同在的喜乐，也满有圣灵的能力，做主的见证。
The crowd that gathered to worship the Lord were filled with his presence, and they were filled with the power of the Holy Spirit to bear witness to the Lord.
但是教会因为遭受政治的逼迫、宗教的逼迫而分散到各个地方。
However, due to religious and political persecution, the church was scattered throughout the world.
经文提到五个地方。
And the scripture that we just read mentions 5 different places.
这五个地方是当时罗马帝国的五个省，就是本都、加拉太、加帕多加、亚细亚、匹推尼。
Now at the time, these five places were under the jurisdiction of the Roman Empire, and these are Pontus, Galatia, Cappadocia, Asia, and Bithynia.
由此看来，神的心意不是要所有的信徒集中在一处。
From this, we can find that the Lord's will was not to have all the believers in just one place.
相反的，神许可教会受逼迫和患难，而分散到不同的城乡，借此把真理真道传到更遥远的地方，他们在那里定居下来，领人归主，建立教会。
On the contrary, God allowed the church to be scattered to different cities, different places.From persecution and tribulation. Why? Well, it is to spread the truth of the gospel to more and more places throughout the world. So when the believers, they settle down, they lead others to Christ and they also establish churches as well.
所以教会无论是聚在一起还是分散到各处，神总与教会同在，直到今天。
Therefore,Whether the believers stay together or they're scattered around, God is always with them through the church to this day.
第二，教会是在地上寄居的。
Second, the church is a foreign body on earth.
寄居这个字，这个表达有双重的意义。
This carries the idea of sojourning, which has a dual meaning.
第一，对当时漂流在异地的犹太人而言，他们当时在异地的生活是暂时的逗留，他们盼望不久就能够返回家园耶路撒冷。
Now the Jews, they drifted from one place to another, and their life was never of a permanent residence, but it was always temporary, and they looked forward to always returning to the homeland in Jerusalem.
第二，对基督徒而言，基督徒的国籍是在天上。
Now for Christians, our home is in heaven. That's where we have our citizenship.
虽然住在地上，却不属于世界。
Although we live in the world, we do not belong to the world.
世界不是基督徒永远的家。
The world is not the permanent residence for Christians.
基督徒在地上的生活是短暂的，神和他所预备的新天新地才是我们永远的居所。
And while the life is short-lived on the earth, the Lord has prepared for us an eternal residence in the new heaven and the new earth.
第三，教会是照父神的先见被拣选的。
Third, the church is elected according to the foreknowledge of God the Father.
这句话很重要，它教导我们关于神拣选的真理。
Now this is very important.It teaches us about the truth of God's election.
第一，拣选者是父神。
First, the one who chooses is God the Father.
父神是三位一体真神的第一位。
God the Father is the first of the triune God.
第二，拣选，拣选是个动词。
Second is election. To elect is a verb.
单从人有限的知识看，拣选体现神的自主权，拣选也体现神超主动权，因为是神拣选人，不是人拣选神。
Election reflects God's autonomy, God's initiative, Him taking the first step, because it is God who chooses man, not the other way around.
拣选还体现神永远的眼光和智慧的决定，因为神的拣选是没有后悔的。
Election also shows God's eternal vision and His wise decision. Once it's made, there's no going back. There's no room for regret.
拣选更是神恩惠的明证，因为在万万千千人中，神拣选了我。
Election is also proof of God's grace.Because among the thousands and millions and billions of people, God elected us.
你问神拣选我们的目的是什么呢？
You might ask, what is the purpose of God electing us?
回答，父神拣选我们，为要我们得着儿子的名分。
Answer, God the Father elected us to give us sonship.
唯有使我们成为圣洁，无有瑕疵。
To make us holy and flawless.
唯有使我们明白他长阔高深的爱。
To make us understand his love that is so wide and so deep.
唯有使我们效法耶稣基督的模式。
It is to make us follow the example of Christ and to imitate his life.
唯有使我们在万般中做他的见证。
It is also to make us witnesses for him among all the nations of the world.
唯有使他的恩典得着称赞。
And this is also to make his grace to be praised.
第三个字是照，照是依照，按照。
Third, let's look at the word according, which means according to.
依照或按照，说明神拣选人不是随便随意的，不是一时冲动做出来的，乃是照着规矩，照着程序，是合情、合理、合法的。
This means that God's election is not random or arbitrary, is not made on impulse, but according to rules and procedures. It is reasonable, logical, and legal.
第四个字是先见，先见就是预先看见或者预先知道。
Fourth, let's look at the word foreknowledge, which means to know or see in advance.
神有先见，说明他有超越的眼光，有超越的能力，有超越的聪明，有参透万事的智慧。
Now, God's foreknowledge shows that he has transcendental vision, power,intelligence and wisdom that can see through all things.
这些特性只有神拥有，人没有，因为神没有将这些特性赐给人。
Now, this foreknowledge is only exclusive to God. Man does not possess this.
你问神有先见，他在哪些事上使用他的先见呢？
Question. If God has foreknowledge, what does he use it for?
回答，用在拣选信靠他的人身上。
Answer, God uses it in choosing people who trust in him.
像今天彼得说的，我们是照父神的先见被拣选的。
And just as Peter said, we were chosen according to the foreknowledge of God the Father.
另外，父神的先见应用在预言主耶稣来世界成全救赎的工程上。
In addition, God the Father's foreknowledge was used to predetermine Jesus' coming to the world to complete the work of salvation.
使徒行传第二章二十三到二十四节，彼得用耶稣的受苦、受死、复活这件事对犹太人讲论神的先见。
In Acts chapter 2, verses 23 to 24, Peter uses Jesus' suffering, his death,and resurrection to speak to the Jews about God's foreknowledge.
他说，耶稣既按着神的定旨，先见被交与人，你们就借着无法之人的手把他钉在十字架上杀了，神却将死的痛苦释放了，叫他复活，因为他原不能被死拘禁。
This is what Peter said. This man, delivered over by the predetermined plan and foreknowledge of God,You nailed to a cross by the hands of godless men and put him to death. But God raised him from the dead, putting an end to the agony of death, since it was impossible for him to be held in its power.
第五个字是被，是被神拣选。被神拣选说明我们是被动的，父神却是超主动的。
Fifth is the word elected.We were elected by God, which translates to, we were not the active party. We were actually the passive party, because God the Father is the one electing.
这进一步提醒我们今天成为基督徒不是偶然的，乃是神照他的先见在万古以前在基督耶稣里拣选了我们。
So this should remind us that us being elected was not by chance, or it was not accidental.That we became Christians today, but it was God who chose us in Christ according to his foreknowledge.
神如何以他的先见拣选，我们没有知识或者能力去了解他。
Now, how God chose to his foreknowledge, we as man are not able to comprehend nor understand it.
但我们知道，不是因为我们的好行为打动了神的心，以致他拣选我们。
One thing that we do know is that our deeds were not the ones that influenced God to choose us.
因为神拣选我们的时候，我们还没有出生，没有好行为呈现在他的面前。
Because when God chose us, we were not even born yet, let alone have any deeds to present to him.
所以神拣选我们是因为他的恩典、他的怜悯和慈爱。
Therefore, God chose us because of his grace, his mercy,and ultimate love.
第四，教会借着圣灵得成圣洁。
Fourth, the church is sanctified by the Holy Spirit.
彼得讲完了父神拣选的工作，就告诉我们圣灵如何在门拣选的人生命里面开始工作。
After Peter finished talking about the work of the Lord, of his election, he told us how the Holy Spirit began to work in the life of the elect.
圣灵是三位一体真神的第三位。
Now, the Holy Spirit is the third person of the Trinity.
圣灵的工作是神使到门拣选的人得以成圣。
The work of the Holy Spirit is to sanctify the elect.
得成圣洁是把人从世界分别出来，使到他们归耶和华为圣。
To be sanctified is to be separated from the people of the world and to make them holy to the Lord.
是的，圣灵使人脱离黑暗的权势，进到光明的国度。
Yes, it is the Holy Spirit that helps us to escape from the power of darkness and to enter the kingdom of light.
圣灵使人脱离背叛、远离、抵挡，进到亲近、相信神、顺服神。
Through the Holy Spirit, we are able to leave rebellion and resistance, and we are now able to draw closer to God, to believe in Him, and to obey Him.
圣灵使人脱离自私、骄傲、狂妄，进到爱神、爱人、服侍神。
The Holy Spirit makes people shun selfishness, pride, and arrogance. And the Holy Spirit allows us to come to love God, to love others, and to serve Him.
圣灵使人脱离犯罪的本性，进到爱公义的本性。
Through the Holy Spirit, we are able to depart from the nature of sin and enter into the nature of love and justice.
圣灵使人脱离怀疑、刚硬、冷漠，进到怜悯、同情、体恤。
The Holy Spirit makes people escape from doubt, stubbornness, and indifference.And instead, enter into mercy and compassion.
圣灵替我们脱离撒旦的权势，进入神爱子的国度。
The Holy Spirit delivers us from the power of Satan and brings us into the kingdom of God where his son is.
是的，圣灵就是这样把我们从世界分别出来，洁净我们，使我们成圣。
So this is how the Holy Spirit separates us from the world.Purifies us and sanctifies us.
圣灵使我们知罪，圣灵使我们悔改。
It is the Holy Spirit that convicts us and causes us to repent.
圣灵给我们新生命，圣灵使我们成为神的儿女。
The Holy Spirit gives us new life and makes us children of God.
这些都是圣灵的工作。
All of this is the work of the Holy Spirit.
弟兄姐妹，我们不能凭自己的聪明的决定、不懈的努力成为圣洁。
We cannot become more holy by our clever thinking or our efforts in the world.
我们成为圣洁，开始于圣灵在我们心中栽种渴慕神的心意和敬畏神的虔诚。
Holiness begins when the Holy Spirit enters into our heart and cultivates us.To desire God and to have a devotion and a fear for the Lord.
圣灵又光照我们的内心，让我们看到自己的过失，领我们到十字架下求赦免，带我们到主宝血的泉源洗干净。
The Holy Spirit illuminates our hearts and allows us to see where we have gone astray. It leads us to the cross of forgiveness and takes us to the fountain of the Lord's blood to be cleansed.
圣灵还给我们赦罪的平安，被接纳的凭据，向我们证明耶稣基督是主，引领我们走光明圣洁的路。
The Holy Spirit also gives us the peace of when our sins are forgiven, the proof of acceptance, and it shows to us that Jesus Christ is the Lord.
第五，教会顺服耶稣基督。
Fifth, the church obeys Jesus Christ.
在前面，彼得讲父神的工作，讲圣灵的工作。
Earlier, Peter talked about the work of God and the Father and of the Holy Spirit.
现在又讲到耶稣基督的工作。
Now, he is going to talk about the work of Jesus Christ.
耶稣基督是三位一体真神的第二位。
Now, Jesus Christ is the second person in the Trinity.
耶稣基督是神成为人，是道成肉身，是神与人同在，是神与人之间的中保，是人类的救主。
Now, Jesus Christ is God, but he became man, the incarnation of man, the Emmanuel, the mediator between God and man, and he also is the savior of humankind.
彼得特别强调基督教会顺服基督至少有三个原因。
Now, Peter emphasized that the church obeys Jesus Christ for three reasons, at least three.
第一，耶稣基督是配得的。
First reason, Jesus Christ is worthy.
腓立比书第二章六到八节说，他本有神的形象，不以自己与神同等为强夺的，反倒虚己，取了奴仆的形象，成为人的样式。既有人的样子，就自己卑微，存心顺服，以至于死，且死在十字架上。
Let's take a look at two passages of scripture.The first is Philippians chapter 2, verses 6 through 8. And it reads, Who, as he already existed in the form of God, did not consider equality with God something to be grasped, but emptied himself by taking the form of a bondservant and being born in the likeness of men and being found in appearance as a man. He humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, death.On a cross.
以弗所书第一章二十到二十三节说，神使他从死里复活，叫他在天上坐在自己的右边，远超过一切执政的、掌权的、有能的、主治的和一切有名的，不但是今世的，连来世的也都超过了，又将万有都伏在他的脚下，使他为教会做万有之首。
Second, let's take a look at the book of Ephesians, chapter 1, verses 20 to 22. God raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come.And he put all things in subjection under his feet and made him head.Over all things to the church.
为此，基督徒理当顺服耶稣基督。
From this, Christians should obey Jesus Christ.
第二，顺服耶稣基督是父神拣选圣灵使他成圣的一个印记跟凭据。
Second reason why we should obey Jesus Christ is that obeying Jesus Christ is the proof and the evidence that this person.Is chosen by God the Father and sanctified by the Holy Spirit.
换言之，我们怎么知道这个人是父神预先拣选的，是圣灵把他从世界中分别出来的，归耶和为圣的呢？答案是看他是否顺服耶稣基督。
In other words, how do I know that a person is chosen by God the Father according to his foreknowledge and that the Holy Spirit has separated him from the world and consecrated him to the Lord?The answer, see if the person is willing to obey Christ.
第三，顺服基督说明这个人已经因信得救了，他已经脱离了以前势力的辖制，现在顺服在新的主人的权柄底下。
The third reason, obeying Christ means that the person has been saved by faith. He has been freed from the control of the previous power of darkness, and now he is obedient to the authority of the new master, Jesus Christ.
第六, 教会们耶稣基督的血所洒。
6. The church was sprinkled by the blood of Jesus Christ.
我们因着主耶稣的血得以称义。
Now, to be sprinkled with the blood is to say that we have been justified by the blood of the Lord Jesus.
我们因着主耶稣的血得门救赎。
We are redeemed by the blood.
我们因着主耶稣的宝血得洁净。
We have been cleansed by the blood.
门着洁净以后，我们开始过新的生活。
And now that we have been cleansed, we begin to live a new life.
我们开始服侍神。
We begin to serve God.
我们能够遵行神的律法。
We can now obey God's law.
我们能够在地上做神荣耀的见证。
And we can be witnesses of God's glory to all the nations of the earth.
弟兄姐妹，以上分享的是主耶稣的教会。
Friends, what I just shared above is the church of Jesus Christ.
教会是圣父、圣子、圣灵的工作。
Through the work of God the Father, God the Holy Spirit, and God the Son, we have the church.
教会不是从人开始的，乃是从神开始的。
We have found that the church was not started by man, but by God.
教会不是人的计划，乃是神的美意。
The church was not the plan of man, but it was willed by the Father.
教会不是人的努力，乃是神的恩典。
It is not by human effort that the church was made, but by the grace of God.
教会不是一群可有可无的群体，乃是门救赎的子民。
The church is not a group of dispensable people, but a blessed and redeemed group of individuals.
教会不是暂时的存在，乃是要存到永远。
And the church does not exist for a period of time, but it exists forever.
现在我们讲信息的第三个方面，基督向教会所怀的意念。
Now let's go into the third main point of today's message. The thoughts that the Lord Jesus had toward the church.
基督对教会所怀的意念可以从他的问安看出来。
We can find more about his thoughts through the greetings of Peter's letter.
圣经说,愿恩惠平安多多地加给你们。
What it says here is, may grace and peace be multiplied to you.
你问什么是恩惠?
You might ask, what is grace?
回答,恩惠是使人快乐的东西。
Answer, grace is something that makes people happy.
恩惠是神给人的礼物,是神给人全备的属灵福气。
Grace is a gift of God that is given to the people. It is a spiritual blessing that is bestowed upon us.
但是恩惠不是我们劳力赚取的。
But grace is something that we cannot earn through our own deeds.
恩惠不是我们配得的。
Nor is grace something that we deserve.
恩惠乃是出于神的大爱，看到我们的需要，慷慨的、白白的赐给我们。
Grace is given to us generously. It is given freely when God sees our need out of His great love.
你问人需要什么样的恩惠呢?
You might ask, what kind of grace do people need?
回答，人需要神的赦免跟怜悯。
Answer, people need God's mercy and compassion.
人需要神的宽恕跟赦罪。
They need His pardon and forgiveness.
人需要神的接纳和洁净。
His acceptance and His cleansing.
人需要正视神的知识跟智慧。
We need to have the knowledge and the wisdom to know more about God.
人需要属灵的看见跟辨别力。
We need spiritual vision and discernment.
人需要属灵的恩赐跟力量。
We need spiritual gifts and strength.
人需要圣灵的重生、永生和永远的居所。
We need the rebirth, the rejuvenation of life that leads to the eternal life and the eternal residence.
这一切都不是与生俱来的，也不是从人间可以买得到的。
Now, we are not born with all of these things, and you cannot even go to the market to buy them.
这些都是神白白赐给我们的。
These things are given to us freely by God.
神不但愿意赐给我们，更是愿意多多地加给我们，甚至大到无可限量。
Now, God is not willing to just give it to us, but is also even willing to give us even more to the greatest extent possible.
而且神也要将平安赐给教会。
God also gives peace to the church.
你问什么是平安？
You might ask, what is peace?
回答，从定义上看，平安是没有骚动，没有暴动。
Answer, by definition, peace is the absence of disturbance and riots.
平安是没有战争，没有纷争。
It is the absence of wars and disputes.
平安是没有困扰，没有烦恼。
Peace is the absence of troubles and worries.
平安是没有惊慌，没有惧怕。
With peace, there is no panic or fear.
从属灵的上面看，平安是与神同行，同心。
From a spiritual perspective, peace is walking with God.
平安是遵行神旨意的结果。
It is the result of doing God's will.
平安是神喜悦的凭证。
Peace is the evidence of pleasing God.
平安是神所赐安慰的话语所产生的果效。
When God comforts us with His word, we have peace.
平安是从神而来，战胜邪恶势力的力量。
Peace is the power of God to defeat evil forces.
平安啊，世界虽然有苦难，但躲藏在主的荫庇底下就有平安。
Although there is suffering in the world today, there is peace in hiding under the shadow of the Lord.
有主同在，有主的陪伴，心中就有平安。
With the Lord's presence and His company, there is peace in the heart.
今天我们生活在一个动荡的世界，一个混乱的世界，一个充满危机的世界，一个令人担忧的世界。
Today, we are living in a very turbulent world, a chaotic world, a world filled with crisis, and a world that's always worrying about the next day.
我们非常需要平安，就是赦罪的平安，与神与人和好的平安。
We need peace today, the peace that comes from the forgiveness of sin, the peace that comes from the reconciliation with God and man.
我们需要平安的心灵，平安的身体，平安的环境，和在基督里出人意料之外的平安。
We need a peaceful mind, a peaceful body, a peaceful environment, and an all-surpassing understanding, which is peace in Christ.
神知道我们需要平安，所以应许说，愿平安多多地加给你们。
God knows that we need peace, so He promised, may peace be multiplied to you.
感谢主，神应许我们的正是我们所最需要的。
So we thank the Lord for what He has promised us, and it is actually what we need the most today.
现在我们看今天的经文在生活上的应用。
Now, let's take a look at some applications that we can learn.
第一，我们要学习用主耶稣的眼光看待今天的教会。
First, we must see today's church from the perspective of the Lord Jesus.
照人看来，早期的教会遭逼迫受患难。
From history, we know that the early church was greatly persecuted.
有的躲起来，有的离乡背井，四散分散四处。
Some believers hid in their homes, others have left their homes and were scattered throughout the world.
他们没有像今天这样的建筑物，他们的信心备受考验。
They had no places for worship and their faith was tested.
但是彼得说，你们虽然是分散的，却不是分裂的。
But Peter said that although you were scattered, you were not divided.
你们虽然四处漂流，在天上却有永远的家。
Although you were wandering about in the world, you have an eternal home in heaven.
神拣选你们，圣灵使你们成圣，耶稣的血已经洒在你们的身上。
God chose you. The Holy Spirit sanctified you. And the blood of Jesus Christ was sprinkled upon you.
你们要服侍永生的神。
To that, we must serve the eternal God.
弟兄姐妹，愿我们用属灵的眼光看待基督的教会。
Friends, I encourage you to look at today's church from a spiritual perspective.
今天有人从外观评估教会，有的人从内部衡量教会，有人从敬拜的方式看待教会。
Today, some people evaluate the church from the outside, from the inside, and maybe they judge the way of worship.
我们却要从圣经的角度看教会。
But when we look at the church, we must look at it from the perspective of the Bible.
教会是圣父、圣子、圣灵的工作。
The church is the work of God the Father, God the Holy Spirit, and God the Son.
神拣选以色列，与他们立约，保守他们直到如今。
We know that God chose Israel and made a covenant with them, which he keeps to this day.
神也必保守坚固他亲手建立的教会。
The Lord will also firmly keep the church that he has personally established.
第二个应用，我们要知道神向教会所怀的意念是赐恩惠、赐平安的意念。
Second, we must know that God's will toward the church is to give her grace and peace.
愿我们也凡事为教会的好处来着想，为教会求平安。
So may we consider everything that is good for the church and seek peace for the church.
当你听到弟兄姐妹遭患难的时候，我们要顾念他们。
When we see a brother or sister in trouble, we need to care for them.
当弟兄姐妹在贫穷之中，我们要帮助他们。
When they are not doing well, we need to help them.
当弟兄姐妹在彷徨、惊惶之中，我们要陪伴他们。
When they are in panic or in fear, we need to keep them company.
因为神向教会所怀的意念是赐恩惠、赐平安的意念。
Because God's will toward the church is to give her grace and peace.
我们是神的儿女，我们要效法神，要祈求肢体得着最好的福分。
We are children of God, and we must imitate God and pray for the blessings for our brothers and sisters.
第三个应用，我们要珍惜大家在一起的机会。
Third, we must cherish the opportunity for us to be together.
圣经说到信徒在世上是寄居的，信徒会有分散的时候。
The Bible says that the believers are sojourners in the world, and believers will be scattered at all times.
是的，弟兄姐妹有的时候会天隔一方。
Yes,Brothers and sisters sometimes go their separate ways.
弟兄姐妹之中有的会先到天家去。
Some will go to heaven first.
除非主来被提教会，不然离别是迟早会发生的事。
Unless the Lord comes to rapture the church, parting will happen sooner or later.
因此我们要珍惜在一起敬拜主的时光，团聚的时光。
Therefore, we should cherish the time that we worship the Lord together and the time that we have fellowship as one.
我们要抓住机会向众人展现爱心。
We must seize every opportunity to show love to others.
今天的信息就分享到这里。
And this concludes today's message.
你坐着为王，到永永远远。 呼求，使我灵苏醒，有复活的生命。你坐着为王，到永永远远，随洪水翻腾，我坚定仰望你。你坐着为王，垂听我呼求，使我灵苏醒，有复活的生命。你坐着为王，垂听我呼求，使我灵苏醒，有复活的生命。
弟兄姐妹，我们一起低头接受神所要给我们的祝福。
Brothers and sisters, let's bow our heads. Let's receive the benediction from the Lord.
但愿天父的慈爱。
Now may the loving kindness of God the Father.
我们主耶稣基督的恩惠。
And may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ.
和圣灵的交通。
And the fellowship of the Holy Spirit.
每一天，每一个时刻。都与弟兄姐妹同在。
Be with brothers and sisters every day and every moment.
直到我们主耶稣基督回来的日子。
Until the day Jesus Christ returned back for us.
愿主牵着您的手。
May the Lord hold your hand.
每一天与你同行。
And may the Lord walk alongside with you daily.
愿他安慰你。
May the Lord comfort you.
扶持你。
May the Lord uphold you.
坚固你。
May the Lord strengthen you.
保护你。
May the Lord protect you.You.
医治你
May the Lord heal your sickness.
给你一切的力量、智慧、资源来为主而活
And to live a life for God with all His resource, His power, and His wisdom.
在生活中活出见证
And to live a testimony in daily living.
结出圣灵的果子
And to bear the fruits of the Holy Spirit.
来荣耀三位一体的真神
To bring glory to God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit.
主必与你同在
The Lord shall be with you.
从今时直到永永远远
From now unto eternity.
但愿在至高之处荣耀归于三位一体的真神
And now may glory to the triune God in heaven.
归于圣父、圣子和圣灵
Glory to God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit.
地上平安归于所有的弟兄姐妹
And peace on earth be to all brothers and sisters.
就是一切爱慕他显现的人
It's all the brothers and sisters who are waiting for the appearing of God.
奉靠主耶稣基督的名
We bless in Jesus Christ's name.
Amen.
Amen.
各位朋友，谢谢您收看今天的节目，愿上帝赐福给您。我们下周同一时间空中再会。